I took up some carpet from the flooring of the chamber and deposited just beneath the cement. I then flapped the carpet back so cleverly, so cunningly, that no eye of the animal kingdom, not even his, could have detected anything wrong. There was nothing to wash out, no stain of any kind, no blood spot whatsoever. I had been too wary for that. When I had made an end of these labors, it was 4 o'clock, still dark as midnight. Well, maybe a bit brighter. It's kind of hard to tell when you're colorblind. As the bell sounded the hour, they came and knocking at the street door. I went to open it with a light heart, but what had I now to fear? There entered two officers.
GPPD, one of your neighbors reported a scream from this house.
We've been ordered to search the premises.
I will need to kill that neighbor next. I smiled, but what had I to fear? I'd bade the pigs welcome. You see, gentlemen, or woman, the scream was my own, in a dream. I was chased by a fire hydrant.
Even so, we will still need to continue our search. Where is the older dog?
He was on vacation. Chicago, Illinois, to go see Lincoln Park.
Where is the old dog's sleeping quarters?
Well, let me give you the grand tour, then. This is my study. This is my basement.
Montressor!
And this is my dungeon with my bottomless pit. Watch out for the pendulum. As you can see, none of his belongings have been touched.
Well, we apologize for your taking your time. We shall be going now.
No. I am sure you two have been working hard tonight. Why don't you rest here for a few minutes?
Well, thank you, sir, if it is no trouble.
No trouble at all. I already tend for the old dog. Two officers are no problem.
So I thought Lincoln Park was in Pomona.
No, they're in Dallas. Have been since August 23rd.
I said Lincoln Park the place, not Lincoln Park the band.
There's a park called Lincoln Park?
Where do you think they got the name?
Well, if it is the park, they don't know how to spell it.
Or they purposely misspelled it, just like how the cool in Kool-Aid is spelled with a K.
The officers were satisfied. My manner had convinced them. I was singularly at ease. They sat, and while I answered cheerily, they chatted of familiar things. But ere long, I fancied a ringing in my ears. No, it wasn't the starship. It was more of the ring that people over 50 can't hear. But still, they sat and still chatted. The ringing became more distinct. It continued and gained definitiveness. Until at length I found that the noise was not within my ears. The sound increased, and what could I do? It was a low, dull, quick sound, much a sound as a watch makes when enveloped in cotton. Why would they not be gone? The noise steadily increased. What could I do? I foamed, I raved, I swore, but the noise arose over all and continually increased. It grew louder, louder, louder! And still the swine chatted pleasantly and smiled. Was it possible they heard not? No, they heard, they suspected, they knew. They were making a mockery of my horror. This I thought, and this I think. But anything was better than this agony. Anything was more tolerable than this derision. I could bear those hypocritical smiles no longer. I felt that I must scream or die, and now again, hark, louder, louder, louder!
Fine!
Villains!
Was I that bad?
That was good. He's just a critic.
I admit the deed. Tear up the carpet. Here, here. It is the beating of his hideous heart. Then, as if God Almighty had stopped it himself, the tune disappeared. Like it had never been there in the first place. I looked up from my position on the ground to see the two guinea pigs staring down at me. Oh, son of my mother.